Hi, and welcome to Watercolor Lessons with Kathy. I'm Kathy Nichols, and I'm a lifelong artist, painter, and teacher. I help students of all ages tap their creativity with watercolor. Watercolor is a great way to express yourself, and it's easy to get started and do. I hope you join me to have fun learning how to paint with watercolor. I can't wait to see your paintings. In our last lesson, we used just two colors to make a simple and dramatic mountain scene. Today, we'll paint a meadow and a mountain using the hairdryer in a new way. In addition to drying parts of the painting, we'll use it to spread a wet wash and watch the paint do its magic. We'll also just use two brushes and wet on wet and wet on dry techniques. If you like, you can use today's painting for a model as you follow along. Spray the top part of the paper without spreading it with a brush. Wet the pans with water to moisten the paint. Add water to the palette so you can wet your brush and mix paint. Load your mop brush with ultramarine blue. Lightly apply the paint on the wet area. Load your mop and add definition. Slightly dry the mop and spread the paint on the upper wet area. Blot to create white space and add detail to the sky. Using the hairdryer on low, gently blow the paint on the lower part of the cloud to make a finer edge.
then dry the area. Blot any stray paint. Load the mop with blue and burnt umber. Paint the upper ridge of the mountain. Clean the mop and select your round with pointed tip brush. Load the brush with blue and add emphasis to the sky. Then load your brush with white and paint clouds on the blue sky. paint the mountain ridge with blue and umber. Wet your brush and blot to soften the ridge line. Wipe and dry the brush and add some white to the cloud. Wet the brush and pull the edges of the ridge line. Clean the round with pointed tip brush and select the mop. Load it with lemon yellow and viridian green and apply it to the lower, dry part of the paper, creating the initial tree shapes and the meadow grass. Here I went back to add some gray to the mountain with a round with pointed tip. Also, pull down some gray to blend with the green treetops. Now load it with green and umber and paint the evergreen treetops and the foliage. Then reload with green and paint in some more greenery. Now dry the wet areas. Mix green and umber to paint more tree details. Load with lemon yellow and viridian to emphasize the deciduous trees. Clean your brush and load with cadmium red to add the flowers. Blot to soften. Refine the flowers with red. Add definition to the green stalks. One final dry. Now relax and enjoy the view.
Please join me for the next lesson when we'll paint a lovely island located in the Pacific Northwest. To send me photos of your paintings, email them to the address in the description below. To be notified when there's a new video, be sure to subscribe and tap the bell. Take care and see you soon.